So a farmer, when he's got a new knowledge, innovation, he wants to share it with other farmers. That innovation works precisely.
Like zero-till.
Like zero-till, exactly. Like the zero-till technique which we have developed about rice-based farming system. I developed that technique for myself. When it was tested, it worked well. Then I took it to some fellow farmers nearby. It worked well for them also. And then it has become a movement. So what we need in the world today to solve the food shortage and global warming problem is an easy method of farming which will do little damage to earth, to the land, and it will also be a climate smart, and it will also fix or carbon into the soil. So this has to be win-win situation. And once we have a technique, it should become a movement. That movement is possible only when the technique is working, only when the technique is simple, only when the technique is affordable and sustainable.
Could you explain a little bit about how you do zero-till on your farm?
Yeah. It is, if you know, the rice cultivation is standing in the water. They do the puddling of the land, and then there is transplanting, bending and transplanting. So that is terrible. It's such a terrible impact on their health. Standing in the water for 7-8 days or 15 days sometimes, and then bending and planting. Very, very bad. So on top of it, by doing so, the health of the soil is gone into drain. Each year we do this rice cultivation and the puddling for it, 20% top silt washes away. 20% silt, beautiful silt of the land, goes down the drain. Plus it requires a lot of labor, plus we have a lot of dependence on the rain. And if any one of these factors fails for any reason, I mean there are at least 7-8 factors, if any one of it varies from time or don't get the right input and all that, there is a big impact on the yield. Quickly, the bad impact is on the yield. So we have got this technique where we make the permanent raised beds only once. And once we have made the beds, we have developed a small tool which with two people you impact it and you make 20 holes. You go on impacting, making holes, and then one person comes and puts the seed into those holes and covers it. Once it is done, then we spray that those beds with selective pre-emergence weedicide. Because of selective pre-emergence weedicide, only rice comes up, everything else doesn't germinate. All the weeds don't germinate. Now, with this, the most important thing is we don't disturb the life cycle of earthworms. So earthworms come in our paddy field in large numbers, which has never been shown in the history of rice cultivation. And now, our farmers, who are 3,000 farmers, all of them, they're saying that, hey, we've got earthworms in our paddy field, so they're all happy. If earthworms come, earthworms go down and up the movement for their hibernation and active phase, anywhere between 4 to 10 feet. Because of this, the air, the oxygen, goes down to the into the soil. So soil becomes aerobic. Then there is no methane generation. If there is no methane generation, one of the problems of the world is solved. Greenhouse gas by rice. It stops completely. And because of the aerobic situation and aerobic microflora in the root zone area, it helps to double the yield. In a plot where a farmer is getting 20 bags of rice, suddenly he gets 40 bags, which he has never seen in his dream also. Forget about him, his whole generations together, they have not imagined. So doubling of the yield is happening. Because, and it's all, what am I telling farmer to do? That don't plow the land, don't do puddling, don't do transplanting. Just do very simple things like, just sow the seed in a particular manner and that's it, forget it. Use less fertilizer, less water. And the most important, another factor is that there is no greenhouse gas generation. But at the same time, this system is able to fix. See, we don't remove the roots of the crop, previous crop. So immediately after rice, we plant either wheat or vegetables or pulses. 4 days or 5 days later of harvesting paddy, we immediately plant this next crop, fifth day. So the land is covered. The global heating, the soil heating is avoided. Plus, a plant has got roots, stem and leaves. So roots are made up of lignin. Lignin getting decomposed in situ slowly does a lot of carbon sequestration, and that is 0.5% per year. Our system is, we have got analytical data now that is able to fix 0.5% carbon into the soil. So if 0.5% carbon is either produced and used, it's fantastic. It helps the crop. Plus, 0.5% is 9 tons of carbon dioxide fixing per year per acre. So we are helping global warming also. So this whole system is such that most important, the technique is simple and farmer has to adopt it as a simple technique. So he reduces his cost of production, he reduces his drudgery, he reduces his dependence on labor, tractor and optimum rain. So three dependencies are gone, his yield is doubled, and he knows puddling is eroding his soil. So that also stops. So these are the things which farmer is concerned about. So that once the doer, the farmer, is happy, it's easy to form the movement. So the movement has begun. He doesn't have to worry about the carbon sequestration.